Hey everybody, it's me, Tim, just finishing up a little training run for the St. Louis Vision Walk next Saturday, October 24th, the virtual Vision Run. We're looking to get everybody involved in whatever way you can with the Vision Run this year. The day of celebration is really the 24th, but just Google St. Louis Vision Walk and your first hit will be all about the Vision Walk and how to get involved. I'm the chair this year, which is kind of amazing to me and really, really fun. And so my family and I have been getting involved with it, and we have a team called the Fam Marathoners next Saturday over the course of 24 hours now. Shannon and I and the boys are going to complete a marathon, a composite marathon. It's going to add up to 26.2 miles between the five of us. The Vision Walk is just really important to me because for about the last maybe 20 years or so, I'm 51 years old today. It's not my birthday, but today I'm 51. Over the last 20 years or so, I've been slowly losing my vision because of an inherited retinal disease called retinitis pigmentosa. And so retinitis pigmentosa is a disease of the light receptors in the retina. And so I see a little bit of a dimmer world. And on a beautiful sunny day like today, I definitely know it's a beautiful sunny day and I can see the blue sky up here and the beautiful trees and the running path where I run. Over the last 20 years, I've slowly lost my peripheral vision. Starting in like blotches around my visual field. If you could just imagine this screen, kind of blotches here and there, if that's your field of vision. And the blotches are just kind of like cloudiness, amalgams of the available colors in the visual field. It's not blackness or even dark grayness. It's just kind of like a schwa of color. And that's just been over 20 years has been just increasing. And it's pretty much my entire periphery right now. But I still have excellent central vision, but that's how retinitis pigmentosa, that form of retinal disease, affects my peripheral vision, and I have a dwindling central vision now. So I can see where I'm going. I can look at my phone here. I can see myself on the screen. I can watch TV. I can read a book. I can see my kids play soccer and stuff like that, but I can't, I can't call offsides, for example, when I'm watching a soccer game. I'm the last person that's going to be yelling at the ref about offsides. I can't perceive that. No way, no how. So, but I can still watch my own kids run around and do their thing. So, RP sucks a little bit, you know, in a life, but I'm really one of the lucky ones because I wasn't even aware I had it until, maybe in my late 20s or 30s. I don't really remember the day I was diagnosed or anything like that, but the St. Louis Vision Walk and the Foundation Fighting Blindness are really great things to get involved with, and if you have the chance to donate a little money to, because the great news about blindness worldwide is that there's a lot of amazing cures on the horizon, really. There's just great things happening all over the world, all over the place, every continent maybe. I don't know if they have anything going on in Antarctica, but I think everywhere else. There's research going on, there's therapies being worked on, and there's real hope for a cure out there. And for me, the thing about RP is I can still lead a pretty full life with it, and I think it's kind of unlikely that I'm going to go completely blind, although I really don't know. I may someday be totally blind, but the thing I worry about more than that is if my boys were to inherit the disease from me, that would stink. But it's a real motivator to be involved in raising money for research and to support the Foundation Fighting Blindness in any way I can. Because so many people around the world, and most especially to me, my own kids might benefit directly from that someday. I might even benefit directly from it someday. But really, 10 million people around the world struggle with blindness in some form, and there's a lot of people that can be helped with your donation and with any support you can offer to the Foundation Fighting Blindness. For us this week, especially with the St. Louis Vision Walk. Look for us on Facebook and Instagram. I'll be getting the word out on those ways. Try to reach out and follow the Foundation Fighting Blindness to stay up on the latest news and to see what's going on and how you can support in your area. And really to everyone who's been involved in any way with my team with the fundraising or just support of me. I get rides everywhere I go. I'm about to go into, here I am sitting outside. This is where I run on the Centennial Greenway here in Ladue, University City, St. Louis, Missouri. And I'm about to go into Schnucks and pick up some peanut butter and some guacamole, I think, and some chips. You know what? My son's gonna pick me up here in a half hour. I always have a ride everywhere I go, friends and family, and so I'm so thankful for that. And for all of you who get involved with donations or supporting our team, thank you so very, very much. It's every single dollar is appreciated, from the big anonymous donors to the friends that donate $5. It's all so helpful and meaningful to me, and it's so, so appreciated. And it's going to an awesome cause where there's so much hope. So thank you guys for everything, and I will see you around somewhere soon, hopefully. Bye-bye. Okay, a little update here. I'm reminded how much it sucks to shop in a supermarket with RP. And anybody with RP will know what I'm talking about, but it's the, you know, the visual just cacophony is pretty intimidating. Okay, I got chips and some hamburger buns, some salt and pepper, and some greens, all right? And someday, shopping in a supermarket, you won't need masks, and maybe nobody will even have RP running around because it'll all be cured. Thanks. See ya.